Hi guys, today's tutorial is on how to make these capes with workable hoods. And these are made to fit the mice that you see in the screenshot here. And the mouse itself is actually a free pattern as well, and you can find that on my blog, www.amigurumitogo.com. And I also have a full video tutorial on how to make the mouse here on my YouTube channel. Today we'll be making the cape, and this would be a great tutorial for those of you who would like to learn how to double crochet. Most of the cape and the hood is done in double crochet. So the written pattern is linked in the description box below. The yarn and hook info will be in that written pattern. Okay, our first row, we start off by making a chain of 19. So make your slip knot. And the slip knot does not count as a chain. So yarn over and pull through. That was your first chain. 2, 3, 4, 5, and keep going till you reach 19. So there's our chain of 19, and we're ready for row 2. And we're going to put a single crochet across that chain. We start with the second chain from the hook. There's your first chain. We're going to go into the second one. Put a single crochet. And now we can continue on with every chain after that to the end of the row. And for me, when I go through a chain, I like to make sure there's two loops of that chain on top of my hook and one loop on the bottom. Everyone does theirs differently and whatever is most comfortable. For me, it's making sure I have two loops on the top and one loop on the bottom. Okay, so I'll continue on stitching across this chain, and I'll meet you back here when we're ready to start row 3. Okay, I've stitched across the chain, and now I have 18 stitches across. We're ready to start row 3, and this is where we're going to start working with double crochets. If we were going to continue on with single crochets, we would chain one and turn and stitch across. But we are working now with double crochets. There are just a couple things to know about making a double crochet stitch. One is it is a tall stitch, about 2 times the height of a single crochet. And the other thing is when we're starting off a row, we need to chain 3 to make up for the height of the stitch over. And I'll show you what I mean here. So chain 3 and turn. And for a double crochet stitch, you need to yarn over before going into your stitch. For this starting stitch only, you'll be going into the 4th chain from the hook, so you can count the V's. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's this one here. So yarn over, go in, grab your yarn, and pull through. You'll have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through the first 2 loops. Now you have 2 loops remaining. Yarn over and pull through the last 2 loops. And you can see how tall that stitch is. So if we didn't chain 3 before we turned our work and just made a double crochet, it would be very difficult to get it done, first of all. So you can see how short that stitch is without chaining 3. So when we go to make our second one, it will be tall. So what happens is it pulls this one that way, and you will get wonky work. So you need to chain 3 for the starting stitch only to equalize the height of those 2 stitches. And yarn over, and you're going to go into the 4th chain from the hook for the starting stitch only. 1, 2, 3, 4. Pull through. You have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over. Pull through the first 2 loops. You have 2 loops remaining. Yarn over and pull through those remaining loops. And you can see the difference there. So for this row, we're going to put 1 double crochet in the first stitch, 2 double crochets into the second, and then repeat that sequence all the way to the end. You should be ending your row with 2 double crochets in the last stitch. So the next one, we need to put 2 double crochets. So yarn over, go in, pull through, 3 loops, yarn over, pull through the first 2 loops, 2 loops remaining, yarn over and pull through. So we need to make a double crochet in that same stitch we were just in. Yarn over, go in, pull through the first 2 loops, and pull through the remaining loops. So there is our first sequence of the row. 1 double crochet, 2 double crochets. Now we repeat that sequence, yarn over and go in, and make sure when you go into your stitch that you're going through both loops of that stitch. Pull through, yarn over, pull through the first 2 loops, yarn over and pull through the remaining loops. Now we're going to put 2 double crochets in, yarn over, go in, make sure you're going through both loops of that stitch, yarn over, pull through, okay, so I'll continue on with this pattern and I'll meet you here when we are done this row. And remember, you'll be finishing off this row with 2 double crochets into the last stitch. Okay, I've reached the end of row 3 and now I have 27 stitches across and the piece is naturally folding around. We're now going to turn our work around, but first we're going to chain 3 and turn. And here we're going to put 1 double crochet in the first stitch, 1 double crochet into the second, and then 2 double crochets into the third. Remember to yarn over, and you'll be putting your first double crochet into the fourth chain from the hook. So count the V's, 1, 2, 3, 4, that one. That was 1 into the first, 1 into the second, and then 2 double crochets into the third. Now we're going to repeat that sequence, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, all the way to the end. Get to the end, you should be ending with 2 double crochets into the last stitch. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you here at the end of the row. Okay, we've reached the end of row 4 and now we have 36 stitches across. Chain 3 and turn. Here we're going to put 1 double crochet into the first stitch, 1 double crochet into the second, 1 double crochet into the third, and then 2 double crochets into the fourth. Repeat that sequence all the way to the end of the row and you should be ending the row with 2 double crochets into that last stitch. So now we're ready for our first double crochet. Yarn over and remember you're going into the fourth chain from the hook. You can count your V's. 1, 2, 3, 4. One in the first. One in the second. One in the third, and 2 double crochets into the fourth. Now repeat that sequence across, and I'll meet you here at the end of the row. Okay, we've reached the end of row 5, and now we have 45 stitches across. Row 6, we're going to chain 1 and turn, and put 1 single crochet in each one of those 45 stitches to the end of the row. So I'll continue on with the pattern and I'll meet you here at the end of the row when we're ready to finish off and weave the yarn tail in. Okay, we've reached the end of row 6. You just cut free and finish off and use a yarn needle to weave this yarn tail in and out here to hide it. So we're just weaving it in and out. And then we can cut free. So there's the first part of our cape done. Now we'll go on and make the hood. Okay, now we're onto the hood piece, and we start with a chain of 33. Starting with the second chain from the hook, stitch across the chain, which means one single crochet in each one of those chains. So I'll continue on with this part of the pattern, and I'll meet you back here when we're ready to start row 3. Okay, I'll finish row 2, and now we have 32 stitches across. Rows 3 to 7 is going to be one double crochet in each one of those 32 stitches for 5 rows. So remember to chain 3 and turn your work at the start of every row. When you yarn over, you'll be going into the 4th chain from the hook for the first stitch only. So I'll continue on with the pattern, and I'll meet you back here when we're all done and ready to weave in the yarn tail. Okay, we're all done the hood piece. Now we're gonna cut free. Leave a nice long tail for sewing. So just finish off. And we can weave this shorter yarn tail in to hide it. Okay, now with this longer yarn tail, we're gonna sew the hood piece. So we just take it and fold it in half. And we're gonna whip stitch these two edges together. So your first whip stitch, make sure to knot off. Make sure you're going through both loops of the first stitch and both loops of the second. So this one we want to knot off. Now we can continue whip stitching along this whole edge. Just going through two loops of that one and two loops of the second one. You don't want any gaps that open along this edge, because this will actually be the back, the center back of the hood. Okay, here we want to knot off. Pull tight. Now we're just going to weave this yarn tail inside those stitches there. Okay, so thread a piece of yarn, a good length of yarn, the same color as your hood and cape, and turn the hood upside down. This is the top side, and this is the bottom side. Turn it upside down, and we're going to sew it to the shortest edge here of the cape. So the one corner of the hood upside down to the one corner of the cape. And just knot these two corners off to keep them tied together. Leave the one yarn tail hanging. And you want to knot this off. Okay, so you'll notice these don't fit straight across. So as you're sewing, we're just going to push the fibers of this hood piece towards this end as we sew, just to shrink it up a bit. And whip stitch the very top edges together. And keep it as even as you can. And here again, you don't want any gaps. So on this corner, I want to knot this corner off as well. So if you're going to have these strings tie the cape together to keep it closed on the doll, then you just want to knot this off. And then just cut this up a bit shorter to get it out of the way. And then you can decide later how you're going to want the closures. Okay, now we're on to the back collar. And we start with a chain of 19, starting with the second chain from the hook, stitch across that chain. So continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of the row. Okay, at the end of row 2 of the back collar. Now we're ready for row 3. Chain 1 and turn. Put 1 single crochet in the first stitch, 2 single crochets into the second. Repeat that sequence all the way across. And you should end the row with 2 single crochets in the last stitch. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we're ready to sew the back collar on. Okay, I'll finish the back collar, ready to finish off. Leave a nice long tail for sewing. Weave that yarn tail from this bottom edge to this top edge. And then weave the shorter yarn tail along the edge to hide it. Okay, we're ready to sew the back collar on. So just take your collar and it's just going to fit like this. Stretch it out a bit. You want this edge and this edge to line up perfectly. And it's just going to sit right underneath that hood edge there. And then just sew it into place. Keep your stitches nice and even and close together. Just stop and make sure that that end is going to reach. And if it doesn't reach, then just stretch it with your fingers. And then just knot this off. And now you can just weave this in and out along here so it's out of the way and hidden. So here you can decide if you want to add a fancy edge to the hood. If you're doing Little Red Riding Mouse, then you don't want a fancy edge. You just want to leave it as is. Just red with no edging. But if you're just doing a mouse, like this one here, and you want a fancy edge on it, which is really cute, then you can choose any type of fun fur or fancy fur yarn. I'm a little bit lost for the names of them all. This one is, I've got it down in the written pattern. You can see the name for this one here. And sometimes when the fun fur, the fancy fur is so thin, it doesn't really do a nice edge, so you just want to double up on it. So I'm going to show you how to add in these little fun edges. Okay, so you just take your fancy fur or fun fur, whatever it's called, push your crochet hook through the bottom edge of your hood, just from the inside. Lay that fun fur over the hook and pull it through. Chain one, and now you can just single crochet all the way around the edge. Okay, so when you make it around the other end, just finish off like you normally would. And then take your needle and weave this up through this edge here to hide it. Okay, so the only step left is the closure on your cape. So I'm going to leave that part up to you. I've tried all different methods here. I've sewn in a button. I used regular sewing thread and just sewed in a button and made a loop out of one of my yarn tails, and it just goes across and closes up, and it works just fine. So if you find the loop with one strand of yarn too flimsy, then just make a braid and sew that, and then use that as a loop to close over your button. This one here, I actually use the fun fur, added a bead, and I use that to tie the cape closed. And this one here, I added in some more yarn tails and I braided them, and I used that and tied that closed. So I'll leave those ideas with you, and you can figure out what works best for your cape. So that's the end of the tutorial. I hope you found it helpful, and I hope you got yourself a little cape made. And if you did make a little cape for your mouse, please post pictures on my Facebook page, Amigurumi Freely. I'd love to see. Thanks so much for watching, and see you soon.